thanks for coming out. My name is Seth, this is my friend Joe, and we drove all the way down from Western Massachusetts to be here in Carbondale. This is my second time here, but it's good to be back, so thanks for showing up.
Thank you.
just down. A joke got up, he pushed Jack to the ground. Then the cliche got to me. Love took hold, now all I see. South Carolina, with a rocking chair sway. She dreams of a wraparound porch and snapping peas all day. I used to laugh at the simple way. Now it's a new world I see. She's 5'5", with big brown eyes. She don't eat meat, but she can eat you alive. I'm a northern star, spinning by the southern sky. Kentucky, keep your whiskey. Georgia, keep your peach. My Carolina is sweeter than sweet. I thought love had given up on me. Now it's a new world I see. Joe Nerney on the saxophone. She's 5'5", with big brown eyes. She don't eat meat, but she can eat you alive. I'm a northern star, smitten by the southern sky. Kentucky, keep your whiskey. Georgia, keep your peach. My Carolina is sweeter than sweet. I thought love had given up on me. Now it's a new world I see. Thanks. So I went to Berklee College of Music. Out in Boston for a year, and I dropped out of college after a year to do this, essentially, to play music for people instead of grades. So I just want to thank you so much for encouraging that kind of decision by purchasing a ticket to tonight's show. I was a songwriting major out there, and It's a weird thing, I think, to be a songwriter, because what happens all the time in conversation, once someone discovers that you're a songwriter, they'll say things casually in conversation where you'll bring something up and then they'll go, oh, well, you should write a song about that. Most of the time, those people are just fucking wrong when they say that. but this was one of those cases where person had a good point, and I just had to slow down and realize that my life at that moment was a song. This is a new song. This is called Our Song. I can write about that's why I don't have a song for you. Each time I try, the rhymes I use feel contrived, feel like a tribute. And I believe our song should be the truth. A song that says we're on the right track, and I've got your back. We forgive each time we're wrong, so that when this world grinds you, a melody finds you. Come and sing it in my arms. This is gonna be our song. Our song is that summer with no AC, first apartment, small town, main street. We're still learning how to sing along. Where the faucet leaks and the bills stack up, we both know that the shower sucks. The summer rather than every Springsteen song. All the songs that go, we're on the right track, and I've got your back. We forgive each time we're wrong, so that when this world grinds you,
gift for for the wife, a seat on the bus. Fill your bags with what you got. I ain't who you are, but what you bought. Now step up to the gallows. Put a rope around your mind. And you won't see the shadows in the darkest of skies. I will hide the shadows in the darkest of skies. A typical day, a two-faced smile can't cut your loss. You're the rank and file. Take your seat with the lost and bitter and clap your hands at the stars and glitter. Now step up to the gallows. Put a rope around your mind, and you won't see the shadows in the darkest of skies. I will have shadows in the darkest of skies. A margin falls, pension plans, pay no attention to the starving man. A plastic house, a bended knee. Savor the wine and believe you're free. Now sign that line for slavery. Though you can't pay that loan, this corporate plantation gonna be your newfound home. Now step up till the gallows. Put a rope around your mind, and you won't see the shadows in the darkest of skies. I will hide the shadows in the darkest of skies. Stand in line, shoot your cuffs. A gift for the wife, a seat on the bus. Fill your bags with what you got. Ain't who you are, but what you bought.
Well, how are you guys doing out there? How's it sound? Awesome. Trust me, it's not. I first played here, I think 3 years ago, there were two people in the audience. I think they were like riffraff that kind of came over from the Black Nugget. But I can't tell you how exciting it is to be outnumbered tonight. Honest.
Yeah.
Feels so good. So thank you guys so much for showing up. A big influence in my songwriting is my older brother, Jamie. He's nonverbal. He's autistic. And when I was about 14, years old, my dad had the bright idea that it would become my responsibility before waking up and catching the bus to school. That my duty would be to wake my brother up and get him showered and dressed and give him breakfast each morning. You can imagine how exciting that idea was to me as a 14-year-old. But it ended up being one of the greatest things that happened to my life when I learned how to communicate to my brother without words. It totally changed my songwriting. It totally changed how I communicate with words. So I often refer to my brother as my greatest non-musical influence. That being said, I feel any day of the week that I get to play music and do this for some kind of living. I feel so lucky. So thank you guys so much for showing up and allowing me to make a stop and feel a little bit lighter sharing these songs and move along to the next town. I really, really appreciate it. Thanks.
Thank you.
When a man's an empty kettle, he should be on his mettle. Yet I'm torn apart. Just because I'm presuming I could be a human if I only had a heart. I'd be tender, I'd be gentle, and awful sentimental regarding love and art. I'd be friends with the sparrows and the boy who shoots the arrows if I only had a heart. Picture me, a balcony, above a voice sing so low. Whisper out the Romeo. Out of here I'd beat. So sweet. Just to register emotion, jealousy, devotion, and really feel the part. I could stay young and chipper, I could lock it with a zipper if I only had a heart. If I only had a heart. If I only had a heart. For the bathroom light, she's changing everything. I know her in this bed, I know her beauty and hesitations. Sometimes she's my train, and sometimes she's the station. I'm good on my own. Don't know this mystery, luster spark that fits like a glove, feels like there's love left in my heart. Now may really good to me, be good man. Now may really good to me, be good man. Still learning to love again. I'm a really good, really good man. My, oh my, looks like the storm has fled. I used to feel the loneliest when someone shared my bed. I've danced through hurting, but I called it being free. No locking and learning under the heat of your body. I may really good, really good man. Good man, still learning to love again. I'm a really good, really good man who knows the best of you. Your memory is unraveled. In my eyes, you find the truth when the judgment cracks its gavel. I kiss you like an outlaw. Hold your heart when it hits the wall. Dance you down to the edge of it all. To the edge of it all. And I may really good, really, perfectly good man. I'm a really good, really good man. I'm still learning to love again. My, oh my, look what the wind blew in. Who's that looking at me? used to be. Best engineered album for a record that I recorded in my parents' basement when I was living with them. After the Grammy, moved out of my parents' basement, and it was great. It kept my mom off my back for about 6 months. That was about it. That was ultimately about it. But it was, I got to go, which was really pretty surreal. You know, there's no food at the Grammys. You can't feed celebrities. So there's, it's a long day. It starts at like 9 a.m. And then there's like a whole pre-televised part. And then there's the televised part, which starts around 4 in the West Coast. And no food during that whole time. And there's about a 20-minute window where everyone kind of piles into the Staples Center for the televised part. And there's in the Staples Center, there's one McDonald's. It's fucking awesome what happens. Because basically, these ravenous, like, Tony Bennett is in an Armani suit in line waiting for, like, a Big Mac. Like, I could not believe. It was so surreal. It was like, it's awesome. Yeah, I should really go next year. It'd be great. John, I made a new record in Los Angeles, of all places. And I wrote 100 songs this past year in preparation of that album. About 80 of those songs really sucked, but we ended up recording 12 of them. And one of the things that kept elbowing its way into my songwriting, despite my better judgment, was my life. And one of the things that sort of changed some perspective for me this year was my parents split up after being together for 30 years. And I'm 26 years old. I certainly don't claim to be an adult yet, but I'm really pretending. I'm trying. And I think it's different to be 26 and have your folks split up than to be a little kid. For me, it felt as though I'd started building my life on these, like, truths, like the grass is green and the sky is blue and my parents are together. And then all of a sudden, something was just out of alignment, and it took me a little while to learn that the grass was still very much green. One of the ways that I kind of cope through things is irony and humor, and there was a lot of humor in that and irony. And starting with my dad got issued divorce papers on their 30th wedding anniversary. So my dad had dinner reservations, and they went out to dinner. And I refer to this as the Last Supper. I'm at home with my sister, and I'm thinking, like, two things. I'm thinking, one, that poor server, he has absolutely no idea what he's getting into. And two, it's just like, what do you say to somebody? What is that dinner conversation like? Well, about an hour and a half after I asked myself that question, both my parents came home, and I heard exactly what you say to somebody in that situation. And at now, a little bit more than a year later, they're both incredible, incredible people, and they're both on their own roads to happiness. But what was unresolved was I couldn't see it go down like that. I couldn't deal with the animosity. I could not deal with that version of that dinner. So I decided to write my own version of how I wish that dinner. You laugh, but it is significantly cheaper than therapy. And this is how I wish it could have gone down. This is called You Wear It Well. I know it's been a while, the table's set for two. We talk about the kids and what we're gonna do. It's hard to shine on a night like this, but I've always loved that old red dress. You wear it well. You wear it well. In the candlelight, I see you glow. Those familiar eyes from 30 years ago. Some try to hide from what the years can do, but time has been a friend to you. You wear it well. You wear it well. You wear it well. I've kept my feelings locked away, so nobody else could see. I wonder if my heart could open up to change, if I wore it on my sleeve. You wear it well. Pick up the check like I should have done all those other nights before this one. So I understand when we say goodbye, if you trade your ring for wings to fly. You you wear it well. You wear it well. You wear it well. So I made this new record with this incredible producer by the name of Bill Leffler. And Bill has worked with the likes of Ingrid Michaelson and Dashboard Confessional and just these really incredible bands. And I chose to work with him based on our very first conversation that we had with one another. One of the first things he said to me was he just came out and said that he doesn't really listen to lyrics. He's way more of a music guy, and he could care less about lyrics. And I'm totally a lyric-driven person. It's like the only thing I'm obsessing about. So I just figured, well, this would be great. Like, he'll kind of keep me out of my own head, and it'll be this sort of good creative collaboration of sorts. And then fast forward a few months, I'm in the recording studio, and I'm in the control room. I'm sitting in a chair, and I'm listening back to that last song come through the speakers. And we finally got the right performance, the right moment of it. And we just, everyone in the room knows, like, that's the one. It's just a great feeling. And as I'm listening to the last chords of the song play, and Bill comes up to me, he puts his hand on my shoulder, and he just goes, "Man, this is so beautiful. People are going to get married to this, What an idiot." Crossed over that center line. But this highway's a mission. Will we make it a tradition? Like a beacon, your door's in sight. And we don't have to feel so lonely tonight. Down the New Jersey Turnpike, over to PA. Shine. I know you're a small audience, but from where I'm sitting, you look like a mighty one. I'm going to teach you a part, and I'd love to hear your voices sing it back. Your lyrics are very simple. It's gonna go like this.
Whoa.
That's it. Let's hear it.
Whoa.
A little bit louder. You keep your part up. We're gonna add another one.
Whoa.
Call this something out of me.
Whoa.
Call this something out of me.
Whoa.
Call it something out. This is a song about loving somebody who makes it really, really, really fucking impossible. Lately you've been sleeping in, haunted by your head again. I'm praying it's a rut you're in. Sinking in the quicksand, and it was never part of my plan to let go, to let you go. I love you still, I'm leaving, 'cause I can't lift you up. I can't lift you up. Spent so much time believing that I could lift you up. I wish I could lift you up. It has to be hard for you, the way I always push through. You can hate me if you have to, if it helps. I could carry on, but I've already stayed too long. Maybe after I'm gone, you'll find someone else. Maybe find yourself. I love you still, I'm leaving, 'cause I can't lift you. Can't lift you up. Spent so much time.
that I could lift you up. I wish I could lift you up. If I could lift you up, I wish I could lift you up.
This man over here is someone that I've been making music with for 11 years now. We've known each other for 11 years. We met when I was 14. I was filling in for this keyboard player in like a Sly and the Family Stone cover band of sorts. That is not what you are about to hear, I can assure you. But the past, 2.5 years, we've been traveling the country together, which is... Really, that started because I needed somebody to share the driving with.
only at night.
But give a warm welcome to Joe Nerney, everybody.
Yeah. All right.
Stripped down to our core,
no disguises anymore. A picture starts to form. We're capable of changing. The scars we see, the scars we hide, make a pattern on the other side. The scars we know, the scars we find, make a pattern on the other side. Songs for you guys. Give a round of applause to Steve for bringing us to town and putting us up and having us, man. I'm so grateful that you're doing this here, and I'm so grateful to come back to Carbondale. I have missed it, and I can't wait to come back next time. I hope to see you guys all again. Over here, we've got some CDs and a mailing list. So please sign up, and we'll let you know when we are coming back through. The other thing that Joe and I are teaming up with on this tour that we're really excited about is we've teamed up with this incredible organization called Child Fund International. And next to the CDs are these green packets. Each one of these packets is actually a child in the need of some help and some support. And what Child Fund does is they help end the cycle of poverty for children around the world. They're in 75 different countries. They've been doing this for 75 years. And about a year and a half ago, I got the privilege of speaking with this couple from Maryland who had been sponsoring a child through this program for about 5 years. The child was from Ecuador. And after exchanging letters back and forth and pictures back and forth with the family, they decided that instead of going on their regular family vacation, they were going to take the family to Ecuador with the intention of meeting this child that they had sort of gotten to know over the course of those 5 years. So they come to this village with no running water, no electricity. It's sort of the story we've all heard before. But the moment of their trip that really got me was when they described the moment they got to meet this child that they had been sponsoring. The child came running up to this couple, and the first thing the child said to this couple was, "Can I call you guys mommy and daddy?" And it hit this couple real hard that it was so much more than $28 a month, but it was hope in every sense of the word. So on your way out, take a look. If there's a picture that sparks your interest, pick it up. There's a little information about each individual child. You'd be sponsoring the individual child. In the back of each one of these packets is an envelope. You can fill out the envelope. You can leave that with Joe or I tonight, and you take the packet home with you. If it's between getting a CD or sponsoring a child, sponsor a child, leave the envelope with me, and we'll just give you a CD on the house. We really believe in this. And once again, it's called Child Fund International. I'll be right over there to answer any questions you guys may have. So thanks for listening. As the sun rose over the sea, everyone was singing in a minor key. Buddhist, Hindu, Jews, Jews and priests gathered around for the Jubilee. Two old ladies still waiting on a sign, growing bitter with age like a yellowtail wine. Shouting at the junkies in the Court Street light, do the next right thing or the next thing right. Whoa, whoa, you're a long way from home. Hear me sing, whoa, whoa, people need a miracle to do the next right thing. Hey, even voices and the quiet preachers. Hey, diddle, diddle, now the feet on screeches. Moaning up the stairs and rolling in bed. She been talking to God since 2 a.m. Saying, I don't wanna go, I don't wanna die. But her sister's gotta see the sea in the sky. You can judge me, grade me, shed some light. Do the next right thing or the next thing right. Whoa! You're a long way from home. Hear me sing, wow, wow. People need a miracle to do the next right thing. Wow, wow. You're a long way from home. Hear me sing, wow, wow. People need a miracle to do the next right thing. Well, this will be our last song. Once again, this is Joe Nerney. My name is Seth Glier. Thank you guys so much for coming out tonight. We hope to see you next time. Go to work. I'm making honest living. Every night I give thanks for all I've been given. In the morning I skim the paper, drink my coffee. With every word I read, what bothers me is I'm becoming indifferent. I can sit and watch a world in trouble crumble from the sideline. Or maybe I can make a difference. How long will I wait, standing still? How long can my faith keep its will? I've been leaving it up to everyone else, hoping it might change itself. To offer up more than my goodwill. How long will I wait, standing still? No man picks up trash around our town, bags on both his hands. Imagine if everybody did. How long will I wait, standing still? How long can my faith keep its will? I've been leaving it up to everyone else, hoping it might change itself. Time to offer up.
Should anyone ever go hungry? Should anyone sleep on the streets? We're drilling holes in our secret land while we're guzzling gasoline. Should anyone ever go hungry? Should anyone sleep on the streets? We're drilling holes in our secret land while we're guzzling gasoline. We've got to end depression, stamp out hate. Love thy neighbor, gay or straight. Let's show a little heart. There's plenty of places to start. How long will I wait, standing still?
Thank you guys so much. Have a great night, everybody. Child of living, it's easy to do. The things you wanted I bought them for you. Let you slide through my hands.
To show we're the same. No sweeping exit.
someday.
We will ride it so.